A couple years ago, I picked up the Herman Miller Embody chair, and for the most part of those 2 years, I've been using it as my daily driver. And I made a video at the time, and in fact, it's actually one of my most viewed videos on this channel. But 3 months ago, I picked up this chair right here. There's a reason why I'm sitting in the Herman Miller Aeron rather than the Embody. So if you're looking at picking up one of these chairs or the Logitech Embody, I would definitely keep on watching, and I'll tell you why I'm going with this chair from here on out. Rather than rehashing my original thoughts about the Embody, most of my thoughts about this chair is still true today. And if you want to watch that video, I'll make sure to link that above or below or somewhere else. Or you can watch any other Embody video, and those points are probably going to be true in those videos as well. Now, let me just point out a couple gripes I had with this chair over the couple years that I've been using it. So, comfort is pretty good with this chair. However, the chair does have a lack of padding. It's designed for flexibility, but you can see the padding on the back, padding on the bottom of the chair is a little bit lacking. And because it has so many plastic articulating points, when you sit down in the Embody, it tends to creak a little bit, especially the armrest. Once you get it adjusted, there's a little bit of flex in here. And if you lean back, the chair will creak and will flex with you. It's part of the design, but it doesn't give you that premium chair feel that you get in a sturdier chair. The other problem with this chair is the lack of proper lumbar support. There is a little bit of lumbar support, and I don't know if you can see it. There's a little bit of white here. This is where it's the lumbar has been worn away, or lumbar in the fabric's been worn away a little bit. You can see it, but it's not very pronounced, and I would have liked a little bit more lumbar support from this chair. And between that and the padding of this chair, isn't very, very thick. You can kind of feel the springs coming through a little bit, or the support springs on the bottom of the chair. So overall, this chair is great. It works well, but it's not perfect. So that's where the Herman Miller Aeron Remastered comes in. And this chair, Herman Miller's been making Aerons for the better part of almost three decades. This chair came out in the 90s, and it's evolved over the years. And a couple years ago, they came out with this remastered edition. Right now, you can get the classic or the remastered. Probably if you go to Herman Miller's website, you will find just the one chair, and it's the most up-to-date with all the options. And there's little tweaks that they've made in the remastered edition. You get a better mesh, you have a better armrest and adjustability, and the full movement tilt function of this chair is upgraded. So let's kind of break that down and talk about that one at a time. So the mesh. The mesh is made out of a plastic rubberized material. It's very breathable. In fact, you can see right through it. And on paper or at first glance, it might not look very comfortable, but if you give it a little bit of push, you'll realize that there is a lot of flex in this material. You might have concerns about durability about this, but at least from what I've seen, and given that there are so many Aerons out there, for the most part, durability seems to be pretty good, and the comfort is very good. You do have a little bit of bounce to it, and because it's so flexible, it's just downright comfortable, quite honestly. So I would say that it doesn't have maybe as much plush as the Embody, but the comfort of the bounce and comfort that the way it flexes under you, there's no hard spots. It's just all around comfortable. Now, moving to the build of this chair, this chair is mainly made out of hard plastics and metal. The Embody has basically no metal in the construction. The Aeron, on the other hand, is a little bit sturdier of a design. So you got hard plastics on the back of the chair. The posture fit lumbar support is made out of plastic, but the armrests, this part right here, in the bottom frame, and the undercarriage part of the chair is made out of metal. So the overall feel, as I sit down, as I bounce around, there's really no creaking, no flexing. Everything is pretty sturdy. So that is a nice bonus, given that you're paying, what's the MSRP, $1,600 in this current configuration for this chair. You would expect that the chair has, you know, no flex, no give, and should be pretty sturdy. Moving on to the armrests. The armrests is significantly upgraded over the Embody. What's so special about these armrests? Well, these are the fully adjustable armrests. The Herman Miller Aeron comes with three different ones. I think you got a height adjustable, you got the fully adjustable, and you have the static armrest. So this is the best version. So you can go out, you can go all the way in. And then one key feature about the armrest is you can actually push it all the way back. The Embody does not have that. So this chair really is designed for use in office scenario, a desk, computer. So, you know, with that armrest all the way back, it allows you to tuck all the way into the table. You know, my tummy's touching the edge of the table and the armrest is still good. So this allows you to tuck all the way in if you'd like to sit like that. There's also the ability to drop the armrest all the way down or to raise. There's a clamp back here. You can unclamp it and up and raise it and drop it down. And this is a metal clamp, so everything is very sturdy. It won't slip. Overall, the design of the armrest and the adjustability is far superior to the armrest of the Embody. I did forget to mention, the Aeron comes in three different sizes, size A, B, and C. This is the size B. For the vast majority of people, size B is going to be perfect for you guys. Unless you're super small or super big, that's the only time when I would take a look at the larger or the smaller sizes. But being that it comes in three different sizes, you can get that customizability to fit you a little bit better than the Embody, in my opinion. The Embody can take small people or, you know, larger people all in the one size because of the adjustability, but because the size of the Aeron is kind of set, size B, I do feel a little bit more comfortable in this chair when I've gotten the correct size for me. Moving on to the lumbar support of the back, this is the Posture Fit lumbar support. The Aeron does come with multiple versions of the lumbar support. There's a flat rubberized lumbar. There is something that you can install. This right here, this has the two-piece Posture Fit. So, and it's, there's a tension adjustment that pushes the lumbar into your back. Right now, I have it set to the maximum extension. So this basically is the most that it will come out. I would have preferred it if the lumbar support came out even further, but given that there is a lumbar and there is adjustability, it is far superior to the Embody because of that. And you know, you can see here that it does actually protrude quite a little bit. So that's a good thing. The last killer feature about this chair I want to talk about is the forward tilting function of this chair. This chair is really designed for people who work at desks, at computers. So this chair has the ability to lean forward by using the toggle at the bottom of the chair. So currently the chair is set up in the lean back or the conventional, you know, you lean back and then you sit upright and everything's fine. But if you toggle this switch forward, it allows you to put this chair in a forward leaning configuration here. In this configuration, you can see the back of the chair is leaning forward a little bit. The armrests are kind of sloping forward and it still allows me to lean all the way back. What's really good about this configuration is if I'm sitting here working on a keyboard, you know, computer, I'm sitting upright, but the back of the chair is still touching my back. Because the seat is leaned forward a few degrees and everything is just forward a few degrees, I still can have that upright, working posture, but still having that proper backrest support and that lumbar support. If I flip it back for you guys to see here, this is a normal chair configuration and, you know, normal sitting upright. I have absolutely no support. So if I toggle this back again, this is great. And again, I can still lean backwards if I want to, but it's just the center, or the spring back center, is just a few degrees forward. And I think if you're looking for an office productivity chair, between the armrest and the ability to lean forward, there's very few chairs out there that will beat this chair in just productivity comfort, in my opinion. Hopefully this gives you an idea of why I went from the Aeron to the Embody. And if you have any questions, go ahead and comment down below. I'll also try to link these chairs in the description down below, again, for your convenience. If you want to use those and support this channel, go ahead and feel free to do so. As always, my name is Stan, and I'll see you guys in the next one.